back with a lady who is doing something incredibly important, trying to stop bullying among girls. Rhonda Orr, you're the president and founder of Rhonda Stop Bullying Foundation for Girls.
Yes.
Fabulous.
Thank you so much. We are relatively new, about 2 years old, as a 501c3 foundation. And we help girls from ages 9 through 17. And we have two different categories where we do a leadership academy. And we do that right here in Prescott. But we've had people come from all over. Even last time we did it was in California. Somebody came from California to our leadership academy.
And you have one coming up.
March 21st. Yes, it's an all-day academy. And we also have Sergeant Steve from his boot camp. He'll be there helping the girls. We have Judge Saleh Hancock, and she's going to be talking a lot about civility. This whole academy goes all day, and then at 6:30, we have a graduation fashion show. And the girls really need a lot of support, because some of the girls that come, yes, they may have been bullied, but oftentimes they're just trying to prevent becoming a victim of bullying. So we need the community and everybody that can to come and support these girls, to let them know that they can be a leader. That's my biggest quest. Our motto is every girl a leader.
So take charge of your life.
To have some
thing.
Right.
Sure. What qualifies as bullying?
You know, that is such an excellent question, because so many people have taken it to the extreme. And kids, you know, they hear the word bullying to the point that, you know, any little irritation, if somebody taps you on the shoulder too wrong, or looks at you cross-eyed, or unties your shoe, you know, they run to the office and they say bullying. And then from coast to coast, everybody has to fill out all this paperwork. And so I did a podcast. So we do quite a few podcasts on this at our website. And I talked about, you know what, this takes away from what actual bullying is. It's abuse. Abuse and bullying are maltreatment, and it's a continuous, sustained, demeaning, degrading, either physical or it could be cyberbullying. Cyberbullying makes up about 70% of the letters that we receive. Dear Rhonda and Dr. Sherry, it's an advice column that we have, and we receive letters from these girls who are consistently cyberbullied. And so we're helping to fight bullying, but we're also helping to fight any kind of abuse that's happening to the young future leaders of our world. And we're hoping to promote more civility in all of society.
Yeah, absolutely. Now, you work with girls only. Do you think there's more or less bullying among girls than boys? Rhonda, what do you think?
Well, it's different.
Okay.
You know, and unfortunately, it does appear statistically to be worse. And what happens is that girls can become best friends, and, you know, they link up really quickly. And it used to be that you did have a BFF forever, but now you might have it for 30 seconds or something of that nature. Girls have best friends that they betray them. And that's so heartbreaking, especially at a young age. And so we started working with girls age 9, because so many girls by age 9 had already been in a situation where they've lost their best friend. And it's debilitating for them. They have to go to another school or be homeschooled, those types of situations.
Because it can get that bad.
Girls can be vicious.
And results. What are the results if someone is bullied? I mean, what things are happening to girls?
Well, I've had so many girls. In fact, at the last educational forum that we did, I had 4 girls come up to me from ages 12 to 14 who said they wanted to commit suicide. And I only had maybe 60 people that were at this forum. So the statistics for 10-year-olds to 14-year-olds is that it's 100% increase in suicides. Girls never even used to think about the possibility of suicide.
Is it more prevalent? Do you think bullying is more prevalent now, or just because of things like the internet, for instance? Is it just different?
Well, people feel removed when they do something cyberbullying, and they think it's funny. And they get a lot of that from reality TV. There's a lot of bullying that goes on TV, and the reality shows, as you and I know, there's nothing real about it, and there certainly is nothing civil about it. So we try to teach the 5 C's: civility, courage, confidence, creativity, We tell girls, you know, internal and external talents, because a lot of the girls think of themselves, well, I don't have any talents. I can't play the piano, I can't dance, I don't do any of that type of thing. And we try to relay the message, there are so many skills that you can learn internally, even such as kindness, understanding, nurturing, those types of things. So we try to simplify it for them and help them to learn that elegant carriage is a huge part of how they portray themselves.
People so self-esteem. Say, well, self-esteem, you kind of fake it till you get it, or what?
Absolutely. That's the one thing. If they get nothing else out of our Leadership Academy, it's to learn that if they walk tall and straight and they have eye contact, they will be less vulnerable to having a bullying experience.
Now, this sounds just like crime for, you know, women in general, how to prevent being victimized in any part of your life.
Well, because it does carry on.
Yeah.
See, that's the problem. I've had many women, and of course that happened to me. That's a lot of what happened to me. As a child, I had a lot of child abuse, sexual child abuse, and then I was bullied. We moved a lot. I went to 5 high schools, skipped my junior year. 3, you know, high schools that I went to as a senior, and it carried over into college. It carried over into being a corporate executive. So I was a corporate executive for 22 years, and 22 years ago I also had another Stop Abuse organization. So this is my passion, this is my mission, to help girls not feel the horror of a crime. Because it is a crime. What happens to these girls is a crime. And girls have been thrown in front of doorways, dropped off after they have been molested. I'm a life coach. Recently, I've been coaching girls that are 14 to 17 years old, basically. They are at an all-therapeutic, all-girls school. And a lot of their troubles stem from having been bullied. They don't know how to go from victim to survivor, to leader. Because at our Leadership Academy, I'll ask, how many of you girls think that you're a leader? And I might have 2 little hands that will tentatively say, oh yes, me, I can be a leader. But really, they don't think of themselves as a leader. And I tell them, you know what? That's an innate quality that you were born with, that you can have all of your life. But when people used to say to me, oh, you're such a survivor, and as I was going through my own journey, I thought, well, what does that mean? I'm just putting one foot in front of the other, and I'm existing. You know, and I was a single mom with a young baby, sure. and it didn't mean anything to me until I went, oh my goodness, this is it. This is our triangle of triumph. And that's why we have that as our logo. You go from victim to survivor to leader.
It sounds absolutely invaluable for these
Thank
girls.
You.
Now, how do they sign up for this leadership event that you're having?
It's a very easy sign up on our website,
okay.
RondaStopBullying.org with one
Good.
S, or they can call me.
Well, it sounds to me like this could definitely change some lives, and that's a marvelous thing, and even keep some girls alive.
It will help do that, and we need community support.
You bet.
Thank
okay.
you.
Okay.
Thank you, Sandy.
Rhonda. Rhonda Orr, thanks for joining us today.
Thank you. Thank you,
Appreciate
Sandy.
It. Great cause. Don't go away. We're going to take a break. When we come back, before and after at Habitat, we'll find out about that.